After the mathematically frugal age in which the Greeks lived, there came a millennium of relative stagnation. Discovery was few and sparse, and generally was concerned with pointless debates. Ad absurdum, how many angels can stand on the point of a needle? A classic argument against the reasoning of the time. In the millennium that we call the Dark Ages, most Western mathematical knowledge was limited to translations by the Roman senator Boethius of the ancient Greeks. He had coined the quadrivium, the four subjects that he felt were necessary to study to understand the mind of God. These were arithmetic, geometry, astronomy, and music. Mathematics was used to explain nature, as was believed by Plato and the Pythagorean cults. The end of this stagnation was marked by newer investigations into ancient mathematics. Adelard of Bath and Robert of Chester provided new translations of Euclid's Elements and a never-before-seen introduction of Al-Khwarizmi's Book of Algebra. This marked the spread of mathematics in Europe. The first great medieval mathematician was Leonardo of Pisa, also known as Fibonacci. He had traveled to the Almohad Kingdom in North Africa as a child, and there he learned and eventually spread to Europe the Hindu-Arabic numbers. Although anything Arabic was viewed with suspicion, these numerals were far less clunky than those of the Romans. One of his more famous ideas was that of a sequence, where every term equaled the sum of the previous two, the Fibonacci sequence. This came to him when he studied successive generations of rabbits. The ratio between successive terms approached, as was discovered, a very special number, the golden ratio. His mathematical knowledge was recorded in his Book of Calculation, or the Liber Abaci. Even hundreds of years before the likenesses of Newton and Leibniz, the fundamental ideas of calculus were being grappled with. 14th century calculator William Heytesbury attempted to measure instantaneous speed as by the path that would be described by a body if it were moved uniformly at the same degree of speed with which it moved in that given instant. That is, the tangent to a curve of displacement. Similarly, the distance covered due to uniform acceleration, later solved by integration, was solved as follows. A moving body uniformly acquiring or losing that increment of speed will traverse in some given time a distance completely equal to that which it would traverse if it were moving continuously through the same time with the mean degree of speed. The dissemination of Greek text and knowledge from other parts of the world helped bring the intellectual stagnation of Europe to a close. People began to observe the world directly and explain empiricism with mathematics. This could be said to be illuminating the West.